scripture this morning. I'm going to start off with a verse from Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because you rejected knowledge, I reject you from being a priest to me. And since you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children. The second verse today is taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 26. Whoever trusts in his own mind is a fool, but he who walks in wisdom will be delivered. Amen. Okay. Well, you guys probably all have about 16 different ideas of where I'm going to go this morning, but I might surprise you a little bit. You know, ignorance does have a terrible price tag, a terrible price tag. But understanding and overcoming our ignorance can really pay off. You know, we hear so much on the news about the financial markets and the world economy, and it goes up and down and all around and everywhere. And we become a lot more aware of our finances. And finances that seemed small back in the day don't seem so small anymore. This is especially true about those of us who are in debt today. However, would you believe that mankind is slipping deeper into another form of debt? One having nothing to do with finances. Would you believe that this debt is about to overwhelm us? Would you believe that we are about to pay for our debt of ignorance? Before we tackle the fine points of this talk this morning, we must first figure out what ignorance is. When people hear the word ignorance, there are many ideas that come to mind. Some think of stupidity. Others think of a lack of caring. Still others think that it's just a fun word to use as an insult and really don't give much thought to it at all. According to Webster's Dictionary, however, ignorance is either a lack of experience or knowledge or the state of being uninformed. Therefore, we are ignorant from birth. It is only as we go through life and learn about the world around us that we can overcome our ignorance. Yet there are some things that we continue to remain ignorant about. You know, for example, most of us don't know a single thing about supernovas. I sure don't. Confess to my ignorance right now. Is that bad? Well, will it cause problems for you in the future? Don't know. But unless you're an astronomer, no. Your ignorance of a supernova probably doesn't mean a whole lot to you. There are times, though, that ignorance can be a very bad thing. Someone's ignorance of a proper ethic at work might find themselves without a job. Ignorance about fire safety could cost people their lives. Ignorance can be a very bad thing sometimes. But you know what the worst ignorance is? The greatest ignorance is when God's laws are ignored. That is when ignorance has reached its worst point. That is when innocent ignorance transforms into sin. Ignorance by itself is not sin, but ignorance of God and His laws will result in sin. You know, all of mankind has sinned in ignorance. We've all done something that we didn't realize it was sin until maybe later on. Maybe it was like breaking the Sabbath or breaking one of God's laws. It may have been coveting and not tithing, giving back to God. Whatever it was, we broke God's law in our ignorance and therefore sinned. And sin is breaking God's law. Now some of us might argue that we're in the clear because we really didn't know any better. However, if you talk to a policeman, a crime is a crime, whether the person knew better or not. God Himself said that a sin in ignorance is still a sin, making provisions for if a person sins unintentionally against any of the commandments of the Lord from the book of Leviticus. In Acts 3, the Apostle Peter was preaching to the crowd in Jerusalem about the sacrifice of Jesus Christ and repentance. He had just finished telling them about Christ's sacrifice and said, "Yet now, brethren, I know that you did it in ignorance, as did also your rulers." We are all responsible for crucifying Christ, because we have all sinned. Peter told them to go, therefore, and repent and be converted, for your sins may be blotted out, and the time of refreshing may come again from your Lord. They still had to, and we still have to repent of our sin, even if we do it in ignorance. You know, a better way to understand ignorance this morning, or the lack of knowledge, is probably to figure out what knowledge is. So let's take a look at that. Webster defines knowledge as information or awareness gained from study and experience. Therefore, knowledge is basically what we intend to kill all our students. The most important knowledge on the face of this earth is knowledge of God and His laws. You don't get this knowledge by looking up facts in some science book. And experience sometimes about God's law can be a little too late in coming to do you much good. In order to have knowledge about God and His laws, we have to study what? We have to study this book, the Bible. We have to stay in His Word. And the best way to study a book and to learn the laws of God is to do it daily. Do it daily, not occasionally, not every once in a while. There are some reasons for ignorance. One actually is God's timing. God says in Isaiah 44:18, "To have the veil of ignorance removed, you must be called by me." It says that God shuts the people's eyes and hearts so that they cannot see or understand. He won't hold them fully accountable until He determines the right time to call them into His service. God has a wonderful plan. His plan, He calls the first fruits first, and then calls the rest to His wonderful knowledge at a later time and place. Another reason for ignorance, laziness. Some people are just too lazy to research God's Word for themselves, and therefore never gain any knowledge of God. While they do gain real knowledge from experience, it's usually too little, too late. That's why God tells us and calls us to be diligent in following Him. King Solomon knew how important diligence was. He says, "If you compare knowledge to spiritual food, then you can see that there is a very valid point." Solomon is saying that we must be like an ant, which works for its food and seeks it out and finds it. And once that ant has its food, it never lets it go. It hoards it up and adds it up until such a time that it is necessary for the ant to use it. And the same with God's Word. We need to store God's Word in His heart, pull it into our very innermost being, so that when there comes a time that we need it, it is there for us to use. We live in a very selfish world. Sometimes we put the physical things of our society ahead of the treasures of God and His precious knowledge. Some of us give up the Word of God because we let the very world today choke it out of us. We're in such active pursuit of our own desires and devices that we don't have time to pursue the knowledge that God can give us. There are examples of ignorance about His own sinful nature and human weakness compared to God's unlimited power. How about the second example? I'm going to take it from the ancient Israelites. And I believe this is an example. If you substitute the Israelites and put in our country's name today, listen to this. God accused them of ignorance. in Jeremiah 4:22. Israel wasn't always ignorant as a nation. Put the United States in there. But as generation after generation strayed further and further from God, they forgot about God's laws. They gave up the knowledge of God and His ways for the world and its supposed privileges. Jesus, He persecuted the church and beat the very people who God called. How bad can you get? Yet God had mercy and called him out of his ignorance. God calls us all out of our ignorance today. We must be very careful as a nation and individuals to admit, to freely admit our ignorance. To freely admit that ignorance that leads to sin, that leads to going against God's very laws. That scripture from Hosea that I read earlier, God mourns in the scripture. He says, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. God is lamenting because his people's ignorance was destroying them.